Two of my nearest and dearest friends also happen to be lyricists. Lucky for me that I just love so many of their songs. They wrote The Way We Were with Marvin Hamlisch. They wrote You Don't Bring Me Flowers with Neil Diamond. The score to Yentl with Michel Legrand. And they're here tonight, Marilyn Ellen Bergman. The title of the album is What Matters Most, and what matters most is friendship and love. And I love the Bergmans, and we've been friends for almost half a century. So we were born
many years apart, but in the same hospital.
Isn't that funny?
I think there was something in the water
that created us.
Yes.
Something.
Brooklyn Jewish
Hospital. How many people were born in that hospital?
I thought it was a good time to sing more of their songs that I love, that I just haven't gotten around to singing. Aren't you glad that you were born in Brooklyn?
Absolutely.
I am. It gives you roots. It gives you a sense of reality.
Absolutely.
You know,
true.
It's an appreciation for the basic things in life, I think.
Few in my life who knew that this one would come true in my life.
There was a kind of tribute to us at the Motion Picture Academy about a year ago. And at one point, Quincy Jones did an interview with Ellen and myself and Barbara. And during the course of this chat, Barbara said, my next album is going to be a tribute to you guys. That's just the way she said it. And how did we feel? I think the first reaction was kind of heart-stopping.
Thrilled.
Thrilled.
I asked them to send me a tape of every song that I haven't sung. And listening over and over, you know, I just picked my favorite ones to make up an album. And I love them.
She's recorded a lot of our songs over the years, over 50. It's questionable whether it's 50
or 52,
but it's in there somewhere. It's a lot.
I've recorded 51 and with this album, 63. Yeah, that is quite a lot, isn't it?
She wanted to sing songs that she had never sung before. Songs of ours that existed and had been performed or recorded by other people, but that she had never done. And that was thrilling. It's all thrilling. It's a thrilling CD.
Yes.
Like a circle in a spiral, like a wheel within a wheel.
I met the Bergmans at the Bonsoir when I was 18 years old, and there was a knock on my little dressing room door that I shared with Phyllis Diller. And when I saw her face, Marilyn Bergman standing there saying, "Do you know how wonderful you are?" That's a moment, you know, that I will remember always. We're like family.
Like a clock whose hands are sweeping past the minutes of its face.
When I heard Windmills of Your Mind, it was so complex, and I just probably never took the time to analyze it, you know, until I heard Alan's record of it, and he made me understand it.
It's a song that we wrote that I never heard her voice doing. I was surprised, as a matter of fact. But then she explained that she never really got the song until she heard Alan's recording of it. And then she understood the song and was attracted to it.
It's like the mechanical clockworks of your mind.
Keys that jingle in your pocket, words that jangle in your head. Why did summer go so quickly? Was it something that you said? Lovers walk along a shore and leave their footprints in the sand. Is the sound of distant drumming just the fingers of your hand? Pictures hanging in a hallway, and the fruit. names and faces, but to whom do they belong? When you knew that it was over, you were suddenly aware that the autumn leaves were turning to the color of his hair.
As she walked into the booth, she said something like, oh, this is a descent into madness here. Exactly. That's exactly what we were using when we wrote the song.
Became really interesting to me. And I love it now.
In the windmills of your
Well, that face has a story. It was written in 1957. I wanted to ask Marilyn to marry me. I didn't have any money. At that time, Marilyn loved the way Fred Astaire sang. Loved, still does. So I sang this song to him, and he said, I'm going to record this next week. I love it, which he did. And I brought home a little dub of it, of his recording, and I asked Marilyn to marry me. And there you are.
How could I not?
Yes.
I just remember hearing or seeing Fred Astaire do it. And I love the fact that Alan wrote it for Marilyn, about Marilyn.
Oh, what a face! That face, it lights up a room.
Again, the treatment, the tempo, the approach is entirely different than anybody that's sung it before. But Barbra had sung in one of the television shows about
Call Me Barbra.
Call Me Barbra, about eight bars of the song to a
athlete, aardvark.
An aardvark.
Some
yeah,
odd animal.
Some odd animal.
That face, that wonderful face, it shines, it glows all over the place. Show me your face. How I love to watch it change expression. Each look becomes the prize of my possession.
Let's take it nice and easy. It's gonna be so easy for us to fall.
I just was in the mood to do some up-tempo songs, and Nice and Easy is a great classic, which was made famous by Frank Sinatra, but I kind of heard it nicer and easier.
I was very surprised when I heard that Barbra was going to record Nice and Easy. I thought, why this album, beautiful ballads, and there's a mood going in this album, would this song not be an intrusion?
I was thinking about it in terms of what it's lyrically saying and tried to do it nice and easy.
The stops along the way.
I think this track is going to be a surprise. I think as many times as the song has been sung wonderfully and originally by Frank Sinatra, I think her approach to the song is most original, and it's a very special track in the CD, I think.
You brought the shadow box?
We
yes.
did.
Oh, yeah.
God, when did I give you that?
That's I don't know.
About, I would say, 15 years ago.
We have to update it. I have to give you some other little things.
Oh, my God, because I love miniatures.
It's so yeah. great.
The dawn is filled with dreams. So many dreams, which one is mine? What must be right for me?
I love bossa nova music, and the Bergmans wrote So Many Stars with Sergio Mendes.
Barbra had a wonderful idea that she could sing in Portuguese part of it.
There's never been a Brazilian translation of the song, actually, but I felt I should sing some of the lyric in Portuguese. So the night before, was it the day before I recorded it, I asked Dori Caymmi to come up with a translation for part of it, and that was fun to do.
She got in touch with Dori Caymmi, who's a marvelous composer.
He was stunned by how quickly she heard that special sound that makes Portuguese what it is and makes it, I think, one of the most beautiful languages to sing in. She got it immediately.
Que estrela vai cantar e o céu clarão beijando o mar. Quem sabe amor em mim também vai rebrilar.
I think it makes the record really hers.
I love Chris Botti, and I asked him to play on a song called Alone in the World, and that was delightful to have him do that.
Alone in the World was written with Jerry Goldsmith for a picture called Russia House. The original record was made by Patty Austin. I don't think anybody else has ever sung this song. So here again, this is another song that really Barbra has given life to.
They're used to writing for motion pictures, and motion pictures, there's a story to tell, and something has to advance the characters. And so, you know, the depth of who they are as individuals, the depth of their love together, kind of displays itself in their lyrics.
Why, I can barely say goodnight.
There are singers who have great equipment, but they don't necessarily have the understanding and the soul.
And she has the intelligence in the equipment, the instrument, and in the heart.
She's the whole deal.
The song I'll Never Say Goodbye is one of my favorite songs because as an actress, I've always wanted to play Juliet, and this seemed to me to be a song that Juliet would have sung with Romeo down at the bottom of her balcony if it hadn't been made into West Side Story already, you know. But it's about, I don't want to leave you for a second, I can't wait till tomorrow. Not only can't I say goodbye, I can't even say goodnight. It's just wonderful to express those feelings.
I'll Never Say Goodbye was written for a picture called The Promise. It's interesting about songs that they can have lives long after the films for which they're written sometimes. I think the performance of this song that Barbra did at a Grammy event called Music Cares for a very big audience. And I think this is the most brilliant performance of this song.
And if I never leave your arms, I really will have traveled everywhere for my. Today.
I always heard her in my mind's ear singing the song.
And I think when people hear this, if she does it in a concert or something, they will say, please not. Don't ever say goodbye.
When the night is wrapped around us and the dawn might come too soon.
They give me, as the actress, a place to go, a place to transform, something to grow into, something to understand more deeply by the end of the song.
Now, when it comes to Solitary Moon, we have a shelf of where some friends of ours, wonderful melody writers like Dave Grusin, and in this case, Johnny Mandel.
I think he was doing a CD for Shirley Moon.
Oh, that's right, he was. You're right.
He was doing the arrangements.
I heard Solitary Moon on a Shirley Horn album. She's one of my favorite singers, and I just thought it was lovely.
We always feel that these melodies have words on the tips of their notes, and we have to find them. It's our discovery, our exploration, so to speak. And Solitary Moon was one of them. Yeah, the same hello, the same goodbye is really a history.
Just as Barbra started to record the song, Steven Spielberg walked into the studio. He was recording next door, and they being good friends, he would say hello. So we talked for a few minutes, and I said to him, coincidentally, you've walked in as Barbara's about to record a song that we wrote with John Williams. And he said, really? He's in the next studio recording. Do you think it would be okay if he came in? And we said, yeah, I think it would be okay. And a few minutes later, John came in. And so we had the composer in the room there. Interestingly as well, he made a little change in a chord in the arrangement. He said there was something wrong in the copying of the music.
And he had never heard Barbara alive in person, you know, so it was a...
He was thrilled. He was really thrilled.
It was the first song that that Barbara ever sang of John Williams, so he was thrilled. He was. Again. What matters most? A song that we wrote with a wonderful composer, Dave Grusin, and it was written for a movie. It's called The Champ.
It's a reunion of a father and his young son, and it's near the very end of the film. And what you hear in probably with the last moments between the father and the son is a song that talks about ultimately what matters is the substance of a relationship, love. That's a statement about what matters most, our feelings and relationships. And I think that's what we write about more than anything else. Even when we think we're writing for a totally different situation in a film, there is a mirror involved. I mean, you can only write from yourself, ultimately.
It has to do with time and experience, and it's their love for each other, Marilyn Allen's romance, marriage, parenting, warmth. It's just everything. It sort of encompasses their whole relationship.
And that's a very personal song to us. It says at one point, It's not, what was something about, it's what we found to say.
Yes,
what is the lyric there?
It's not how far we traveled on our way, but what we found to say.
It's not how far we traveled on our way, but what we found to say.
Whenever Alan sings this song often. And when he gets to that line, it's what we found to say, I always kind of choke up a little bit. So I realize there's something very personal about that song.
It's placed last on the record because it's the lingering thought, the lingering feeling that I wanted. It's great to have, you know, friends for that long a period of time that you love, and that you, we're family. What are,
yes,
you know, it's like
exactly.
You can't choose your family, but you can choose your friends that become your family. So
that's a good
note
to end on.
I think so. With love.
Yes. That's what matters most.
Yes. Goodbye, honey. Goodbye.
Bye.
Okay, I'm going to run because I'm so late.